Quazi here, and in this video, I'm gonna share with you the power of writing things down. Before I begin this video, I wanted to quickly announce that I'm doing a free giveaway of my book, Life Mastery. If you want to enter into a competition to win this book for completely free at the end of the week, just comment Life Mastery down below. And at the end of the week, we're gonna pick one lucky winner to get this book for free in the ebook format. It's around $12 on Amazon, but you can get this for completely free if you just comment Life Mastery down below. Also, I'm super excited to announce that the free one-to-one consult for the Reality Mastery program is still open. So please wait till the end of the video for the announcement on that. So with that, let's get started with this video. Now in this video, I want to talk to you about the power of writing things down. And recently I got into a realization of why this is so effective. And, you know, I want to share with you what my life was like before I used to write things down and what life was like after. Essentially, before I wrote down my goals, the first time I actually got into this concept of writing my goals down was through Think and Grow Rich, the first book that got me into the Law of Attraction. And it's a book by Napoleon Hill in which he says you must write down a goal card of whatever it is that you want and read it to yourself every night before bed and every day first thing in the morning. So last thing before bed, first thing in the morning. And it's a very, very powerful practice, for sure. Now, as I started to do this for areas of my life, certain areas of my life, my goals started manifesting. But, you know, it wasn't the most effective way, but it was still very, very, very effective. And, you know, especially for getting a 4.0 GPA. I remember I wrote down, oh, Quazi's gonna get a 4.0 GPA, Quazi gets a 4.0 GPA, as though it was in the present tense, as though I'm already doing it. So that's a very important requirement as well. So the power of writing things down goes and extends much beyond writing your goals down, but it's, you know, a game changer for goals, really. But I saw that whenever I started writing things down that was on my mind as well, I was much more clearer and I gained much more clarity in my life. And after studying lots of biographies of successful people and reading their books, I saw that all successful people at some point in their lives, they wrote down their goals. They actually wrote down their goals and what they wanted in their lives at some point, at, you know, whether it be in a Moleskine notebook or anywhere. But rest assured, it was written somewhere. You know, recently I've been reading Grant Cardone's book, and he says that every single morning he gets a legal pad and writes down 10 of his goals. Every single morning, every night before bed. You know, he doesn't, you know, some mornings he may miss out, some nights he may miss out, but usually, majority of the time, he writes down his goals every single day. Now, I personally don't think that you should do that because, you know, for me, writing goals down every single morning, every night before bed, it could get really, really repetitive and boring, to say the least. And we know that the most powerful way to manifest realities is when there is genuineness and feeling. And then there is juice in manifesting the goals. If you're just doing it out of obligation, it's never going to be effective. It's always going to lack sincerity. So that's why I would advise against doing it every single night. But what I do advise is doing it every single month, and I will get into that later. But for now, really just understand that all successful people do this, and it gets results. Therefore, why not do it, right? Now, the most important thing I saw that I did attention exercises, consciousness exercises, writing goals down, the most important benefit that I got out of doing all of this is that it provided me more clarity. And that's why in the Reality Mastery program, we're so focused on doing worksheets, because really putting things down on paper raises clarity so much. And clarity is super important because what happens is when you have more clarity, you have more certainty. You automatically get yourself in a state where you can gain more certainty. If you have more certainty in what it is you want, you activate a powerful force called outer intention. And if you didn't know what outer intention is, click up here. It's essentially a concept from a book called Reality Transurfing. And it's written by a Russian quantum physicist called Vadim Zeland. And in this book, you know, he breaks down a lot of esoteric concepts. And, you know, he teaches a lot of metaphysical concepts to us and really explains in a quantum model why manifestation occurs and how the reality, how events in reality occur. Now, in this book, he talks about intention and how it can be broken down into inner intention and outer intention. Inner intention is defined as the resoluteness in your decision to act in order to get something. Outer intention is defined as the resoluteness in your decision to have something. Doesn't matter, you know, how it comes to you, somehow it just manifests. Writing things down on paper actually activates outer intention much more. It is much more closer to activating outer intention than inner intention, because why outer intention is much more powerful is because this intention doesn't belong to you, but it belongs to you at the same time. It is the divine worldly intention that makes everything manifest almost magically. It's the reason that Jesus Christ was able to walk on water, because he didn't have a single doubt in his mind that he would, for a second, even drown. So writing things down on paper, first thing it does is it creates clarity. When you have clarity, you can gain more and more certainty of what it is that you want, because you get clearer and clearer and you're less muddled about it. So clarity leads to more certainty. More certainty leads to more resoluteness in your decision to have something. So this, again, leads to outer intention. Now, I'm not saying that writing things down on paper alone will help you get to your goals, but you know, maybe you'll need to take some action, maybe you'll need to visualize a little here and there. It's up to you to know what it is you need to do and create your own law of attraction sadhana or cocktail of spiritual practices that help you move towards your goal every single day. Also, an interesting study I saw showed that you are 42% more likely, people who wrote down their goals were 42% more likely to get to their goals than people who didn't write down their goals. So there's that as well. So essentially, if you want to activate this powerful outer intention, you want to get to a point where you're completely resolute in your decision to have something. There is not a single doubt in your mind that you're going to get it. The only way to do that is through writing your goals down. Well, one of the best ways to do that is through writing your goals down. So make sure you're taking advantage of that. And now what I'm gonna do is share with you an exercise that I do every single month that helps me create this certainty. The exercise is, what you wanna do is at the beginning of every single month or the 31st of the previous month, you want to write down goals in four areas of your life. And these four areas are health, love, relationships, wealth, career, vocation, and finally, spirituality. You could even add a fifth one, but I wouldn't suggest doing so. Four or five is the maximum I prefer to stay at, because any more than your intention energy gets divided up into too many areas, and it's difficult to manifest all of these goals. So ideally, you want to keep it to around four to five areas. If there's academia, you know, I had academia back when I was in college and I wanted to get good grades. I also had character goals because I wanted to improve myself and become a better person, but spirituality, it can fall under that as well. So essentially, under these four areas, you want to create your goals and whatever it is you want to achieve. Make sure they're measurable, make sure they're trackable, and you have some metrics to measure them. Because I saw that without clear metrics, I wasn't measuring my goals. So experiment with this every single month. Get a moleskin notebook. So I wrote down mine in this moleskin notebook, and I still use it to this very day, and it's really, really useful. It's around maybe $10 on Amazon. So make sure you get one of these bad boys and write down your goals every single month. It's a game changer for sure. So really, I want you to remember that every single successful person wrote down their goals. This is just a practice that cultivates success. When you write down your goals, you're 42% more likely to achieve them. When you write down your goals, you gain much more clarity in whatever it is that you want. As a result of gaining more clarity, you gain more certainty in your decision to have. As a result of increasing your certainty in your decision to have, you activate outer intention, which then gets the whole world engaged in giving you what you want. The powerful exercise that's been a game changer for me personally was writing down my goals every single month. Not every single day, that's unnecessary, but every single month, writing down your goals in four different areas of your life. Health, relationships, spirituality, career. These four areas are generally the most important areas for people. So these are the areas you want to write down your goals in. And as a bonus, what I like to do is at the end of the next month, I like to do a review on my goals. And I like to see, you know, what's worked and what hasn't and what iteration I want to make for next month. By no means should you set any realistic goals. My parting advice to you is to set goals so large that they ignite the genius in you. So with that, I conclude this video, and I sincerely hope this helped, and I hope you liked this. Make sure you leave me a comment to let me know what you thought of this. If you liked this, just let me know, hey Quazi, I really like this. If you didn't like this, just say, hey Quazi, this video was really bad. You know, don't make videos like this ever again. whatever it is, just let me know, give me feedback, so, because there's more where this came from. Also, if you're new to the channel, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and also hit the bell so you're notified of any new video that I put out. And also, I'm excited to announce that I'm growing a massive Facebook group where I'll be sharing all of this kind of stuff and much more. So make sure you take advantage of that and click on the link in the description below to join, and I hope I see you there. Also, I'm excited to announce that the Reality Mastery Program is still open for enrollment. And if you didn't know what the Reality Mastery Program was, it's essentially the most powerful paradigm of manifestation. Now, what I found in my personal life was that, you know, writing goals down wasn't enough. Doing visualizations wasn't enough. Doing meditations wasn't enough. I was never getting the goals that I wanted. It was always little things like a parking space, checks in the mail, or very, very little things that didn't really matter to me. Never the transformation results that I wanted. Until I found out about identity shifting. And then my life transformed forever. It was never the same again. I shifted into the attractive version of myself, the attractive version of Quazi. I attracted my dream partner, the exact partner that I've dreamed of getting for 2 years. I shifted into the entrepreneur version of myself. I was able to quit my 9-to-5 job and earn the income that I wanted to earn. I shifted into the fit version of myself and I manifested the exact dream body that I wanted to, when I thought it was completely impossible for me to gain muscle for around 2 to 3 years when I've been working out. And I know all of this is possible for you as well, because I'm helping my clients do this in their lives every single day. So if you want to take advantage of this opportunity, make sure you click on the link below to sign up for the free 1-to-1 consult while it's still being offered. We're completely booked out for June, but we still have spots available for July. So make sure you take advantage of that. And I hope I see you at the free 1-to-1 consult. Till next time, peace.